No! No! The season can't end like this! No!
All right. Welcome to the season finale of Minnesota FFA Weekly. Let's check it out. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Swinging like Ali, backing out bodies, standing on top. Welcome to the last episode of the Minnesota FFA Weekly Show.
I know.
I'm your host, Lafe Arsold, and we have quite an amazing episode to wrap up this season. In today's episode, we're going to learn the 3 G's from our Sentinel, hear from the star farmers and learn how they're outstanding in their fields, and learn the key to finding success with our treasurer. Then, we're going to celebrate some of our seniors, hear from Lavyne Rada, the Minnesota FFA State Program Manager and Regional Supervisor, and hear some of the opportunities you can take advantage of during our state convention next week. This is lining up to be a great finale, so we best get moving. Up first, we're going to give it to Savannah as she talks about grace, gratitude, and grit.
Hello, and welcome to Sav's segment on grit, grace, and gratitude. You see, as a gymnast, I had to use grit to get through the many killers I had to endure, the pull-ups on the bars, and the many falls on the beam. I had to refine my routine with grace and also understand that every fall on the equipment made me a stronger gymnast. And because of my strong support system and team, I was able to express gratitude because they helped me become a stronger individual both in and outside of the gym. The first point is grit. You see, we all live in this crazy and yet beautiful world. We are all in the same storm. We are just on different boats. High school seniors are on a completely different boat than the one I'm on. My brother is on a completely different boat than the one that I'm on. I challenge us to be persistent and use grit to navigate through the crazy storms that life throws at us. The second point is grace, which means courteous goodwill. You see, it's important to tell yourself well done and to give yourself grace for how hard you are trying. I just finished my junior year, and even though there are things that I wish I could have improved, it's important to sprinkle on grace for how hard I have tried and how hard I can continue to try in the future. The third point is gratitude. I miss people, I miss hugs, and I miss get-togethers. But I also cherish the memories that I've been able to have and look forward to a promising future. Someone once told me that the seed that is sown in private is the seed that is harvested in public. And what this means is that we can still invest and be invested in. We can still grow in our leadership skills, and we can still show our thankfulness and gratitude towards the people, memories, and experiences that have helped shape us into the person that we are today. So I am thankful for this grape juice. I challenge you to use grit, grace, and gratitude this week. So there you have it.
Thanks for that message, Savannah. Now we're gonna hear from the star farmers. These students have grown their projects and are now outstanding in their fields.
I am Owen Ocker from the Holly FFA chapter in Region 1. I started my SAE of hay and straw production in the summer of 2017 when I planted 5 acres of alfalfa hay and baled straw for my father's wheat crop. I started to cut my hay in 2018 and increased my acreage in 2019 to 12 acres. I cut, rake, bale hay, fix my equipment, and market my hay and straw. I spend hundreds of hours each summer on my SAE and get help from my younger siblings. Just last year, I made over 4,000 small square bales. Through my SAE, I've made over $7,000 towards my college education and also own all of my equipment that I use. I'm also the chapter president. This fall, I will be attending North Dakota State College of Science to pursue degrees in agronomy and precision agriculture. I would like to thank my advisor, Mr. Swanson, my teachers, including my former principal, Mike Martin, and my current principal, Kelly Anderson, my superintendent, Phil Jensen, my bosses, and my parents, Amy and Jeremy Ockery, for encouraging me and helping me to succeed.
I am Elaine Chute from the Aiken FFA chapter in Region 2. I live and work on a 300-acre farm where we raise hay, goats, and beef cattle. I have a herd of 8 Nubian dairy goats, which I started in 6th grade when I bought my first doling. In 10th grade, I won the Minnesota Youth Beef Experience Program's South Devon Heifer. She had her first heifer calf last year. I am responsible for caring for my livestock and making all management decisions regarding them. I am very active in 4-H, having held various club and county officer positions. I show my livestock in 4-H and have shown at several different regional and state shows. Next fall, I plan to attend South Dakota State University for agricultural education. I want to be a high school agriculture teacher, an FFA advisor, and a professional livestock judge. I want to thank my parents, Phil and Colleen Chute, my younger brother Owen, my past and present FFA advisors, Mr. Larson and Mr. Highmark, and my Minnesota Youth Beef Experience Program mentors, Todd Leonard and Lance Brantner, for helping me succeed in high school, FFA, and my SAE.
Hi, I'm William Poe from the Jackson County Central FFA Chapter in Region 6. My diversified crop production SAE began in 2017 when I rented 37 and a half acres. Each year I've expanded my operation, and going into 2020, I'll be farming 139 acres. I've grown my knowledge in plant science, farm business management, grain systems, crop production, and much more. In 2019, I was able to make a capital purchase in a 20-foot John Deere no-till drill, which I'll be using this spring. In addition to FFA, I have been in 4-H, National Honor Society, and golf throughout high school. I plan to keep farming while I attend college, likely being at North Dakota State College of Science for a 2-year degree in farm business management. After college, I plan to return home and continue to grow my operation. I would like to thank my parents, Kenny and Marie Pell, all three of my advisors, Mr. Voss, Mrs. Bidney, and Mrs. Anderson. Thank you to my landlords, Maynard and Audrey Johnson, and those in the Winn Allen Trust for the opportunity to rent land. I would also like to thank those who have taught me a valuable skill and helped me get here.
Katie Fitzgerald from the Triton FFA chapter. I am the 2020 Region 8 finalist for Star Farmer. My SAE is raising and operating my herd of 13 head of registered Angus and Shorthorn cattle for production and showing purposes. My responsibilities are feeding, bedding, checking water, monitoring health, cleaning facilities, halter breaking, and daily hair care of show cattle. I have grown my herd from 3 to 13 head in the matter of 4 years while becoming a more seasoned showman and cattle owner. I was fortunate to be a recipient of an Angus heifer through the Minnesota Youth Beef Experience Program. When I'm not on my family farm, I show cattle on the county, state, and national level. I'm an active member in 4-H, a member of the State and National Angus and Shorthorn Associations, and mentor youth through the Goodyear County 4-H Beef Mentorship Program that I created. Next year, I will attend South Dakota State University to major in animal science and egg business with a plan to pursue a career as a ruminant livestock feed nutritionist. I'd like to thank my advisors, Mr. Ickler and Mr. Dinsey, my parents, David and Ann Fitzgerald, my feed nutritionist, Leanne Waugh, and my siblings for always pushing me to success and being there for me every step.
Dang, those students really are stars. Best of luck next week as we announce the results at our virtual state convention. But now let's hear about our traditions that some of our chapters hold that mean so much to our students.
Hi, this is Isabel Patterson from the Kenyon-Winnemingo FFA chapter. One of my favorite chapter traditions is after our annual pancake breakfast where we feed our teachers, community members, and parents, we like to take the leftover pancake batter and make fun-shaped pancakes like tractors, pigs, and sheep.
Hello everyone, my name is Michaela Thorson and I'm from the Howard Lake Waverly-Winstead FFA chapter and Region 4. Today, I'm going to be telling you about my favorite chapter event. So this past year, in 2019, our chapter held our first annual alumni tractor pull. We called it the Dust Them Off Tractor Pull. Although I have many other events that I enjoy throughout the year with our chapter, this has to be my ultimate favorite. My favorite part of the tractor pull is getting to visit with community members and talk about the amazing things our alumni does throughout the year, but also our chapter.
My favorite tradition is cleaning our Adopt-a-Highway road ditch before our May meeting. We get together before the meeting in which we elect the next year's officers and clean our road ditch. We take a fun picture and we get to eat some food before the meeting.
Hi, my name is Amanda Webley and I am from the Hancock FFA chapter. My favorite chapter tradition is when we feed our local farmers. When we feed a farmer, we bring them a lunch that consists of a couple sandwiches, a bag of chips, an apple, a dessert, and water. And one of my favorite quotes is, "Once in your life, you will need a doctor, a lawyer, and a preacher. But every day, three times a day, you need a farmer." and this quote is so true, and giving back to our farmers is a small way to show our appreciation for all that they do for our FFA chapters, communities, and our world.
Those are the traditions that make this state association so great. But now, pull up your chair as we join Maddie at Fireside Chats, where she talks about finding success.
Hey folks, and welcome to Fireside Chat today. We are going to be talking about success, what it looks like, what we can be doing, and what Norman Borlaug, our very own Minnesota native, has done to make a difference in this world.
We know success looks different than it maybe did before. And success always looks different no matter what the time is or who you are. But there's one thing in common that all successful people have. If you haven't heard this name before, you've definitely been impacted by it. Dr. Norman Borlaug was born and raised in Cresco, Iowa, and we love Iowa. He then became a student right here at the University of Minnesota Twin Cities, where he studied plant sciences and agronomy. Not long after graduating, Borlaug was sent down to Mexico, where the population was struggling with a disease in their wheat crops. And they were sent in very limited resources, a very strict budget, and it wasn't really exactly great conditions, especially since he was living in areas of very high poverty. So as Dr. Borlaug was down there, a young man, keep in mind, he came up with a solution that would consist basically of selective breeding. And there were two different crops, alternating seasons in Mexico. And so he introduced the idea of traveling back and forth so that way they could have twice as many generations in a year. This was a risky move, and he had a lot of opposition because they did have such limited resources. But he saw this as an opportunity to be extra diligent with what they had. In the end, he became basically the main component of the Green Revolution, which ended up feeding not just Latin America, but it ended up spreading to Europe and India and Asia and all across the world, where he was able to save billions of people from starvation, and we still use his technology today. While he was working in the wheat field, his wife came out to him one day and told him that she just got a phone call. He was selected as the winner for the Nobel Peace Prize. Dr. Borlaug had just been the recipient for the highest honor available to man, but he didn't stop there. He understood that success was something that had to be maintained, so he continued to collaborate with others, agriculturalists, politicians, farmers, and all sorts of other people who had the same goal to feed the world. So what made Dr. Borlaug so successful? It was because he looked for reasons, not excuses. When they had limited resources and a limited amount of time to be able to come up with a solution, he saw that as an opportunity to be even more diligent with what they did have. When he received the Nobel Peace Prize, instead of settling for the fame, he decided to use that as a platform to help more people make a long-term difference for after he was gone. So what do you look for? Reasons or excuses? If you're a student and you fail a test, do you use the excuse that this content was simply too hard and you didn't know what you're talking about? Or do you see this as an opportunity to learn something new and try harder to study for next time? If you're an athlete and you have a bad practice, do you simply use the excuse that you're not athletic? Or do you find the opportunity in being able to become better and faster and stronger? There's one thing that successful people in our lives teach us. And there's one thing that they have in common. It's what they look for. Do they look for reasons or excuses? Successful people will find a reason to do what they want to accomplish, because there will always be a way to find an excuse to get out of it. So I challenge you to be like Norman Borlaug and look not for excuses, but for reasons.
Can't wait to find my success. We're going to be able to do great things with that knowledge. But now, let's talk about last week's socially distant career development event. Last week, you were challenged to the famous big contest. Today, we are excited to share those results. Let's check it out.
This week's socially distant career development event was the famous big contest, where students participate in an online quiz to test their knowledge about FFA trivia. For the first division, in third place, Hallie Poplar from Howard Lake Waverly Winstead. Second place, Crystal Gunderson from Howard Lake Waverly Winstead. And in first place, Mallory Thorson from Howard Lake Waverly Winstead. In our Forever Green Hand Division, in third place, Megan Radka from Macquarie FFA. Second place, Lindsay Nowick from Howard Lake Waverly Winstead. And your champion, Alana Shu from the Aiken FFA chapter. Congratulations, everybody.
Bam! Now it's time for the weekly challenge. This week's challenge is to tune in next week for the virtual state convention. Can't wait to see you there. Now we're gonna hear from Lavyne Rada, the Minnesota FFA State Program Manager and Regional Supervisor.
Hello, Minnesota FFA and friends. I am Lavyne Rada, the Minnesota FFA Program Manager and Regional Supervisor. I am lucky enough to work with and support hundreds of agriculture, food, and natural resource teachers across the state of Minnesota as they build the foundation of Minnesota FFA, our local chapters. I know our teachers and local chapter leaders have been working hard and continue to work hard to provide experiences for all of our students, even in unique situations like now. I also know that FFA and agriculture education will continue throughout the summer and into a new school year in the fall, even if it looks a little bit different. As we prepare to celebrate the 91st Minnesota FFA Convention next week, let's remember to take a moment and be thankful for the experiences we have and those who have supported us along the way. Let's be thankful for the moments we have right now, each and every day. And let's look forward as we continue to make a difference for those around us. I recently read something in a book that has continued to remind me of the influence we have every day. Michelle Poehler shared, "You don't have to have a certain title, award, or following to be intentional when it comes to influencing those you care about." FFA members and friends, now more than ever is a time to be intentional. As we prepare for convention next week, take a moment to explore the opportunities available as we grow and develop our skills and passions, as we learn about a new career or college, and connect with FFA members from across the state. Our FFA convention has no limits this year, as everyone is invited and able to attend. So let's make the most of it and be intentional about influencing those we care about. We look forward to seeing you next week and beyond.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Rada, for all you do to strengthen our regions and local programs. And now, let's check out some of the opportunities you'll have next week during our virtual state convention.
Next week, we will hold the Minnesota FFA State Convention virtually May 19th through the 21st. Tune in for sessions, workshops, and much more. We'll have over 35 workshops being held to give insight on careers and different pathways. Make sure to download the mobile app for more information and to stay up to date and on time.
Those sound so amazing. Can't wait to see you all there. But before we end this season, we want to recognize some of the seniors of Minnesota FFA. We sent out a form, and now we're going to show some of the seniors that have helped make this year so successful.
One of my fondest FFA memories is attending state convention. It was so cool to meet people from all over the state, and I loved singing with the choir. Another great experience was being a part of the Miracle of Birth Center last year at the State Fair. Thanks for the memories!
My fondest FFA memory is traveling to South Africa this past summer with members from my local FFA chapter for 15 days to learn about the culture and farming practices there.
My fondest FFA memory is from this past year as I got pied in the face at the Region 5 Winter Conference, or Leading the Challenge. The region officers put together a community service project where we collected canned goods. The top three officers with the most canned goods got pied in the face.
My fondest memory of FFA would be showing sheep at the Minnesota State Fair. Just being with my friends and working together with each other creates memories that I'll never forget. And then after shows, walking around the fair grounds is always fun.
My favorite memory is jumping into the freezing cold lake with Staples FFA after their barn dance and banquet.
For my favorite FFA memory is going to Washington, D.C. for the WLC.
My fondest FFA memory would be
the dress-up days that we have for FFA Week, and to top off FFA Week would be the Egg Olympics that we do every year.
My favorite FFA memory is going to be this past year at National Convention. I loved meeting all the new people that I got to see, and I loved the Old Dominion concert because we were almost in the front row.
My favorite FFA tradition is the Randolph Tractor Parade. We host the largest tractor parade in Minnesota, and it's a way that we can bring a community together by just driving tractors around the school.
My favorite FFA tradition is my dime with my parlay team. We acquired this dime before we went into final round for conduct of chapter meetings our first year together, and ever since then we've had like a little ceremony we do with the dime before we compete for good luck.
Is these notes. Every year we have a fall party and we get to do notes of encouragement to everybody. We sit in a circle and everybody has a note card with their name on it. We pass it around and everybody writes words of encouragement for that person.
My favorite FFA tradition is when my chapter, the Thief River Falls FFA chapter, goes on bus rides or van rides. We always sing a few songs. One of our most favorite is Rattlin' Bond.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Lorraine, and I'm from the Cedar Mountain FFA chapter, and the greatest lesson that I've learned from FFA is the value of teamwork. Next year, I will be attending SDSU, majoring in agronomy.
The greatest lesson FFA has taught me is how to stay true to myself, whether that be building relationships and staying my spunky self with others, or working on the farm and doing what I love. FFA has taught me many great lessons that I will cherish forever.
The greatest lesson I learned from FFA is just to get involved and like make it a goal to meet new people, because there's a lot of cool people out there, and just like strengthen your relationships because you never know where they're going to take you.
If I could choose one thing FFA's taught me over the years, it'd probably be leadership, because I remember being a shy 8th grader first year and I was such a president for almost everything, and I dreamt one day that I could be that person for the younger kids. And through FFA and experiences, I was able to obtain those leadership skills to become president, and I know those skills will help me lifelong.
The greatest lesson I've learned from FFA is to step way out of your comfort zone, because no matter what, you will achieve things that you never thought you would be able to, and you have amazing people beside you to help you along the way.
Being a part of FFA has taught me the importance of service and being there for your community whenever help is needed.
I would have told myself to get involved as much as possible right away, because FFA is a whole lot of fun. And also to try and meet a lot of new people, because people in FFA are so much fun and you can make a lot of new friends through it.
The biggest part of advice that I would have given myself when I was a freshman is don't ever plan on getting back home on time. You're always gonna be later than what you're invited.
The biggest advice I would have given myself my freshman year in FFA is don't compare yourself to those around you. You see, flowers and Christmas lights look nothing the same, but they have a purpose that is their own.
So the best advice I'd give to myself when I joined is don't be afraid to try new stuff, try as much as you can, and don't worry about what others think.
One piece of advice that I would have given myself would be to never be afraid to grow out of my comfort zone. Some of the best experiences that I've had came from being willing to do things that weren't so comfortable at the time. And as a result, I have grown as a person, had some amazing experiences, and met some of my closest friends.
When I think of FFA, I think of pure joy. Joy of finding lifelong friends, a career path I am passionate about, and a voice in the agricultural industry.
Something about FFA that makes me happy is all the new friends that I've met in it, and my advisors that have helped me through a lot of things and opened up many new doors for me. And I'm just thankful for all that, and it makes me happy.
Something about FFA that always makes me happy is everyone's always positive, and they always want to make people around them better, and it's just a very fun environment.
Hey Minnesota FFA, my name is Olivia Leslie and I'm from the Staples Motley FFA chapter. And one thing that always makes me happy about FFA are all the people that I've met.
Something that always makes me happy about FFA is thinking back on all the memories I made
friendships that will last forever and opportunities of a lifetime that have shaped me into who I am today.
FFA has prepared me for graduation and beyond by allowing me to develop confidence, leadership, independence, and gain lifelong friends that I will cherish forever.
Being an FFA has prepared me for my graduation by helping me realize what I like to do after high school. And it showed me that I really enjoy learning about animals, which aided me in my choice to pursue a degree in veterinary technology.
This brings us to the end of Season 1 of the Minnesota FFA Weekly Show. But before we go, our team just wanted to say thank you for watching the Minnesota FFA Weekly Show. You all are a huge part of the success for our year. To our students, thank you for being the passionate, positive selves that will lead this association into a bright future. To our advisors, thank you for all the guidance and support you continue to give us to continue to make this association so successful. And to our sponsors and supporters, thank you for supporting the young men and women who wear these blue jackets. You're investing in the future of agriculture. Thank you for joining us. See you next week as we finish off our year. Stay groovy. Do you think the Kool-Aid Man was rebelling because no one makes doors big enough for him?